Hi, this is Nancy Ralfsma with OnPoint-TV. Today I'm going to tell you about some of my favorite hand stitching tools. So these are going to be tools that I'm going to use, tools and threads that I'm going to use when I'm doing hand applique or even if I'm putting the binding on a quilt. So I'm going to start with probably one that I think is the most important, and that would be the Roxanne's Glue Baste It. This glue has been around for a long time. Roxanne and her mom were very, very popular and very, very instrumental in the whole hand quilting and hand applique kind of arena. So this glue is absolutely fabulous. And here's a couple things I like about it. First of all, it comes in a nice big bottle. They do sell some smaller bottles. This is one that they sell. Now this has a little bit of a larger tip on one end. And on the other end is a flat flow tip. There's a teacher out there that uses this for her quilt-as-you-go technique. My favorite kind, though, is when it's in this type of a bottle. It's a 2-ounce bottle, and it comes with this fabulous tip and a cap. And when you're putting down the glue, now I'm just going to dab some here, you can put down one dot wherever you need it. So it's going to be perfectly positioned every time. If I had something that I'd say that I wish they would change on it, I wish they would give you 10 of those little red caps in the container, because that's what I lose more times than not. And once you lose it, there's just no way to keep the glue safe in there. So I'm having to buy a new one. So don't lose that little red cap. It's very, very important. Keep in mind, in the instructions, they actually say you should take this off, rinse it out, and store it with the little white cap, that you shouldn't be storing it with this. I, of course, am never gonna follow the rules. So when I do it, I knock all the glue down, and then I'll make the glue come up and get any of the glue out, and then suck the air back in, and then that'll keep it clear. And then if I don't lose my little red cap and I store it standing up, I'm good to go every time. So it's a problem if I'm traveling and it tips, but just kind of keep that in mind, all right? Next, staying on the glue front, it would be glue sticks. Now, I love the Uhu Glue Stick. This is gonna be when I'm wanting to put bigger pieces down. So let's say I'm wanting to take and put this entire piece down on something. You can take it and just smear it on the back like that, and then that's going to hold down. It does not hold down as well as the Roxanne's glue. And the Roxanne's glue, you'll see me use that in the quilted tiles series. I use that to hold the bias tape down. And the Uhu is really good when you want to hold, but it's not as permanent or as strong, I guess, as the Roxanne's. But then I found this. This is the Bohene glue pen. So there's the glue in here. There is some replacement glue, so you can put it in here. What I love about this is when I'm wanting to get the glue right where I need it. So when I'm doing one of my hand applique techniques is to put the glue on the edge, and then I'm going to push this over and hold it down. It's just fabulous. I mean, it's going to go where I need it to go. It is the perfect density too. I don't know how to describe it. It's not too smushy. It's not too dry. It goes down beautifully. I used to do this also when I'm doing English paper piecing, getting that fabric around it. So the Bohene glue pen, and like I said, then you can get the little replacement glues that go inside of it. Now we're going to go to needles. Again, I'm going to the Roxanne company. This is the Roxanne needles. I personally hand applique with a very small, so I'm not even sure if you can see that, that is a size 10 between. Now, a between is considered one used for hand quilting because it's short and you can get it to do the rocking. I use it for hand applique. For me, the smaller the needle, the smaller my stitches. If I try to use a longer needle, then I end up with longer stitches. Having said that, some of the best hand appliqueers I know do hand applique with a long Milner's needle, but they always are going to use either a size 10, 11. My friend Cheryl even uses a 12, and I'm telling you, that needle is about as fine as a piece of hair, but that's what she uses for hand applique. So never bigger than a 10, so that means you want to do a 10, 11, or a 12, and the Roxanne's betweens. And I just love the little glass container, and it has a little seashell because they're in Hawaii. Just love this. And it might seem expensive, but there are a lot of needles in there. So when you're using a needle that's small, the hardest thing is figuring out how to thread it. That is done with the Clover Desk Threader. This has been a mainstay with me for hand stitching ever since they came out with it. Can't live without it, and the older I get, the more I depend on this. So the idea, and it does come in a lot of fun colors, the idea is you set it on the desk. It's got the needle. My needle is going with the eye down. Then I'm going to put my thread, and in this case, I'm talking silk thread that I'll talk to you about in a second. Hold it loosely at the side, push the button, pull it up, and ta-da, it is threaded. So that is the Clover Desk Threader. I don't know, if you're over 50, don't even try to live without one of those. I also love this little case for holding my needles. Now, this was made by my friend Sue, who owns a quilt shop in New Zealand. Hi, Sue. She made that for me, the cutest little design, and I love having it so that my needles can just go right in there, safe and sound. So something to hold your needles in. When I'm doing stitching, my thimble. This is gonna crack you up. This is the thimble that I love. It is maybe $2. I don't know. They're really cheap. They're plastic. I like that my nail comes out of it. I don't like a thimble where my nail is being pressed on it, and it stays on perfectly. And just like my pin cushion, I'll go upstairs and be going out to, and I'll realize, oh my goodness, I still have my thimble on my finger. I find them to be very, very comfortable. Thimbles, though, are a very personal choice. It's very hard for you to find your perfect thimble. So take some time. But this little guy, this little cheap guy, he's been one of my favorites for a long time. Now we're going to go to scissors. Karen K. Buckley is a professional teacher. She teaches hand applique. She has been not only one of the most popular hand applique teachers, I highly recommend you take a class with her, but then she started coming out with tools, and some of her tools are things like her scissors and then the perfect circles that I'll tell you about in a second. But her scissors, something about the way that she makes them, they cut beautifully exactly where you want it to cut, and they also cut all the way to the tip. And that's really important when you're doing hand applique, that you have a pair of scissors that'll cut all the way to the tip. And these have a nice big pink handle. I think she was thinking about me when she made that. And then there's a new little pair that she has. It comes with a nice cover to keep the point from being, you know, coming through something that's not supposed to come through. And these, again, are going to cut right to the tip every time. You don't want to have to go all the way in your scissors to cut right to where you want it. You want to have a pair of scissors, cuts right in. Karen K. Buckley, fabulous pairs of scissors. Then we're going to go to, we'll talk about perfect circles. So if you're doing any hand applique that has a circle in it, you need to get some perfect circles. Again, these are from Karen K. Buckley. This is a Mylar template plastic, so it does not melt. I've showed you how to use this in an earlier video on hand applique, but these, again, Karen K. Buckley perfect circles, these are always going to be in my hand applique tote. Then there's Thread Magic. Now, Thread Magic is a silicone. There used to be one called Thread Heaven, and Thread Heaven, they just don't make it anymore. So the idea with the silicone is that you're going to run it, your thread over the top of it, and then take your hand and run it through one time. And that is going to give your thread some stability. So if you're using a thread that has a tendency to fray a little bit, using something like the Thread Magic is going to keep it from fraying, and it makes it a little bit stronger. I use that a lot when I'm sewing down a binding, because my binding is going to be sewed down with a cotton thread. And so I'm always going to put some Thread Magic on it so that my cotton thread lasts a little bit longer, and then it's not going to fray. The thread that I use for hand applique, though, is a silk thread. So here is a couple of different silk threads. This is the YLI. That's the name of the company, YLI. They're 100 weight silk thread. They also have a 50 weight. That is used for other things, not hand applique. The 100 weight is a very, very fine thread that is going to make your stitches so much more invisible. I guarantee you, if you're not happy with your hand stitching, try silk thread. So I've got the black and the white, which are always going to be used. And then the last one, now this is one from Superior. It is also 100 weight, so Superior threads. What I want to show you here is this color. Now in YLI, it's color 235. It is just this kind of taupey color. In the Superior, it's color 367. This color I'm going to use really good English here, is the hidiest color thread you'll ever use. You can use this thread on just about any color, unless it's really dark or really light. Then you use your black white. So here I have black white and this funny taupe color. Those are going to be the three colors that I'm going to do 95% of my hand applique in. Now, there's teachers that do use a color for every single thing they're doing. More power to them. For me, I just need to make it simple. So I've got just my three colors. Sometimes I might get a red thread or a yellow thread. But for the most part, here is the colors. So did I cover everything? I've got my thimble, my circles, my... Yep, I covered everything. So those are my favorite hand stitching tools, kind of leaning towards the hand applique. Hope you like this video. If you have any trouble finding any of these tools, be sure to send me an email or comment below. My email is quiltingwithnancy@gmail.com. Be sure to subscribe to our channel, hit that notifications button so we can let you know when we're putting out a new video. Have a great day.